With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello everyone, let's solve the question. The question says, figure shows a conducting circular loop of radius A placed in a uniform perpendicular magnetic field B. A metal rod OA is pivoted at the center of the loop. The other end A of the rod touches the loop. The rod OA and the loop are resistance-less, but a resistance having resistance capital R is connected between O and a fixed point C on the loop. The rod OA is made to rotate anticlockwise at a small but uniform angular speed omega by an external force. So we are given two parts to solve. So in part A we need to find the current in the resistance R. So what is given situation to us? We are given that there is a circular loop. So it is a circular loop and there is a rod which is pivoted at the center of this circular loop. So let's suppose that it is the center of the loop and it is the point A and it is the rod, and this rod and this loop is resistance less and there is an external resistance which is connected between O and C. This is point C and its resistance is R. So now it is given that there is an external magnetic field which is going inside the plane. So there will be an external magnetic field which is going inside the plane. So what will happen? We are rotating this rod anticlockwise with an external force. So we are applying force here and we are rotating this rod in anticlockwise direction with angular velocity omega. So what will happen? That flux change will happen through this OAC area. So there will be a EMF generated across OA rod. So first we need to calculate that EMF. So let's suppose that it is our rod. So it is our rod OA. And let's take a small length element dx here. And it is situated at a distance of x from O. And magnetic field is given to us, which is B. So we need to find out the velocity of this particular length element. So its velocity will be in this direction. So it will be V. So we can find out the velocity. V will be omega R, where R is the x. So we can write, we know that EMF across this rod can be written as EMF can be written as B V L, where V is the velocity of this length element and L is the length of this length element. So we can write it as, what is our L? L is dx. And what is our V? V is equal to omega x, because this dl is situated at a distance x from the center. So we can put values in this equation and calculate it. So in this case we have to take integration on both sides. So we will write B. What is the value of V? It is omega x. What is value of L? It is dx. And we have to take integration from 0 to A, because its length is A and we are going from O to A, then 0 to A. Limits will be taken. So we can further solve this. So our EMF will become, B will come outside, omega will come outside. We are left with x square divided by 2. Now we will put limits here. So after solving this, we will get B omega A square divided by 2. So it is our EMF generated across this OA. So there will be current flowing in this direction. We can find it, the current flowing in this direction, because this current flow will resist the change in magnetic flux. So if we apply the right hand thumb rule here, so magnetic field generated due to this current will be coming outside of the plane, which is opposite to the given external magnetic field. So this will, current in this direction will oppose the magnetic flux change. So now we can easily find out the current. So we know that current I is given by EMF divided by capital R. So we can put values here. What is EMF? It is B omega A square divided by 2R. So this will be our answer, final answer for part A, which is current flowing through R, which is B omega a square divided by 2r. Now what is part b? In part b, what we are asked? We are asked to find out the torque of the external force needed to keep the rod rotating with constant angular velocity omega. So in this case, what is happening here? As current is flowing in this direction, so there will be magnetic field. Magnetic force will be acting in this direction. So it will be acting in the middle point of OA. So we have to apply external force, capital F, in the opposite direction and at the middle point of OA to keep this rod rotating with constant angular velocity. So we can find it out. So in part B, we have to balance torque due to, so torque due to magnetic force, which is FB, it should be equal to torque due to external force. Let's call it E external force, FEX. So now we can put values here. So what will be the torque due to the magnetic field? So magnetic force is acting between the at the middle point of the rod. So we can write it as, what will be the magnetic force? It will be given by I dl. So it will be A B. So we can write it as, because length of the rod is A, so now it is acting at the middle point. So we will write A by 2 equals to, what is the torque due to external force? So F multiplied by A by 2. So now here we can easily solve it. So what is the value of current we can put here? So our value of current will be B omega A square divided by 2R multiplied by A by 2 is equal to F multiplied by A by 2. So you can further solve it and we will get, here we have A and B also. It is a current value, so we have to multiply it with A and B also. So A and B. So after solving this, we will get B square omega A 4 divided by 4R. So this will be external torque. External torque. So this will be our final answer. So what is our final answer? External torque required to rotate the rod OA with a constant angular velocity will be B square omega A raised to 4 divided by 4R. This will be our final answer. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.